checkpoints, its regulation, and the apoptosis pathway. So first, the first thing is that we have to understand that what is cell cycle. So can anyone tell me about what is cell cycle? Anyone? So now I come to the what is the definition of the cell cycle. So what is cell cycle? Cell cycle is an ordered series of events. It is a period from one division to the next division, from the end of the one division to the next division. So now the question is, what is it do? What is the meat of a cell cycle? So cell cycle replicates its content, the content of the cell, and after that it equally distributed its contents into its daughter cells. And the second thing is that the duration of the cell cycle, which is a very important thing. So the duration of the cell cycle also varies from one cell to another. As for example, in eukaryote it takes a few minutes, but in case of Eleutheria, another example, approximately it takes 12 hours to complete a cell cycle. So now I will come to the phases of the cell cycle. So the phases here, the cell cycle is eventually differentiated into two parts. The initial phase, the interphase, and the end phase or the mitotic phase, or we can tell it the divisional phase. This is a the G1 case. After the G1, it comes the S phase. After the S, the G2 phase. And after that, the N phase. And in between the N and the G1, the G0 phase will also come. So what is the G0 phase? G0 phase, when the cell sees the division, it means in this phase the cell can't divide. The cell ceases division. Here the cell division will not occur. Example of a G0 state is the neuron cell. Here the division is not occur. Cell division does not occur. So the G1 phase. So G1 phase, in this phase the cell will metabolically active and it doesn't replicate its DNA, but it actually collects all other things that are required for replication to occur. So these are the G1 phase. Next, the S phase, which is also called the synthesis phase. In this phase, the DNA synthesis will occur. That's why it is called the synthesis phase. Now, after the S phase will complete it, it will go to the G2 phase, the Gap2 phase, where the from DNA to RNA, RNA to protein, protein to enzyme, these all things will produce and it will be developed. So the cell will increase in size, and after that it will go to the N phase. Okay, to the N phase, right? The division will occur. What is the A phase? What is the division of the A phase? So, we can describe the A phase by four divisional stages. What are they? The first one is the prophase, which is the first stage. The second one is metaphase. The third one is anaphase, and the fourth one is telophase. Okay. So what is prophase? This is the first step of the mitosis or meiosis, whatever is that. This is the first stage of the divisional stage, and here the chromosomes start condensing. Right? If we think it as a cell, then the chromosome in the prophase start decondensing. Mani chromosome group ekhane atom condense chole geche ate tara next stage e metaphase e atom chromosome hote pare. Thik ache, tar jonno tara age eigulo shudho moto kacha obosthay thake. সেখান থেকে যখন আমরা মেটাফেজে আসবো তখন জিনিসগুলো আরো প্যাচিং অ্যান্ড দ্য নিউক্লিয়ার এমব্রিওনা অ্যান্ড দ্য নিউক্লিওলা স্টার্ট টু ডিসঅ্যাপিয়ার ইন দিস প্রসেস. দিস আই কম টু দ্য মেটাফেজ. সো হোয়াট ইজ দ্যাট? ইফ ইট ইজ আ সেল, দেন ইন দ্য মেটাফেজ স্টেজ দ্য ক্রোমাটিন স্টার্ট টু অ্যাকুমুলেট ইন দ্য ইকুয়েটর লাইক দ্যাট. It aligns with the equator, and the spindle fiber and the attachment of the spindle, this is the spindle fiber, and the attachment of the spindle fiber with the centromere will occur in this stage, the metaphase stage. And the third stage is the anaphase stage, where the chromatid start to move in the two opposite poles, like that. this is an anaphasic where the chromatids start to move to the opposite group, to opposite group. And the last stage, the fourth stage is the telophase where the chromatid or the chromosome going to the opposite group and the same plane is formed and the nucleolus and the nuclear envelope start to reappear or start to get in and form the two daughter cells. This is all about the in phase or mitotic phase or the divisional phase. Right? So, the next thing. We going to the next slides or the other parts of the cell cycle. That just in the first introduction about the cell cycle, atom regulation part. Now I come to the regulation part. So again, and but just to be aware in this only, the cell cycle logic is that we have two requirements for successful long-term cell proliferation. What is that? What is that? The steps of chromosome replication division cycle occur in a correct and fixed order, right? This is the main thing, which is that steps of chromosome replication division cycle occur in a correct and fixed order. It can't be overlapping. It has to happen in a correct order and a fixed order also. The DNA replication, which occur in the S phase, always precede chromosome segregation. Meiosis or A phase followed by cytokinesis. After the chromosome segregation or after the separation of the chromosome, the cytokinesis will happen. So what is the cytokinesis? Cytokinesis is the division of the cytoplasm. And after that, the two daughter cells will be formed from a parent cell. So the second point is that, this sequence of chromosomal event repeats with a period equal to mass doubling time. The time required to double the cytoplasmic mass. The next slide is that the first state of constraint is necessary to maintain the integrity of the genome. The second state is necessary to maintain the cell nucleocytoplasmic ratio. This is the main thing, that is, the cell cycle will actually maintain the nucleocytoplasmic ratio. Either that it will not can't be occur or the daughter cells that will be formed if the nucleocytoplasmic ratio will not proper or same, then the daughter cell will be abnormal or it will be disorganized or etc. So the last point is that the current sequence of events is a robust characteristic of the chromosome cycle. If an early event is blocked, this is the main thing, that if the early event is blocked, then usually none of the following events take place, suggesting that cell cycle events form a dependent sequence. It will depend on its previous sequence. Either its previous sequence will not happen properly, then it will not go on. We'll stop there. So, the next slide, the next thing is that I will describe in the earlier the phases of the cell cycle, it will over. Now I will describe the cell cycle checkpoint. So the main thing of the today's topic is a checkpoint. What is this? So Hartley and Wiener first introduced the concept of the checkpoints when the underlying regulatory principle became clear. They proposed that the cell cycle event must be coordinated with one another. Example, it is critically important cell not begin mitosis until replication of the genome has been completed. The alternative could be a catastrophic cell division in which the daughter cell failed to inherit the complete copies of the genetic material. So, the next thing is that the metaphase anaphase boundary, and the cooperation progress through the chromosome cycle can be halted at this checkpoint if the conditions for successful cell division are not met. Okay, so what is that? If we consider the cell cycle checkpoint, so what is this? The G1 cycle, it comes to the S cycle. Where does DNA synthesis occur? It occurs the DNA synthesis. From the S, it will form the G2, where the RNA, protein, and enzymes will form and alter also. Also done. And after that, the in phase. After the in phase, it again comes to the G1 phase. Okay. Now, what are the checkpoints and where they are situated? The first checkpoint situated here. The first one, G1 and S checkpoint. Between the G1 and S phase, the first checkpoint. The second checkpoint situated between these. The second one, between G2 to N. And the third, the metaphase, we can differentiate the in phase or the minority phase into four stages. Prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. So, the third checkpoint is situated between the metaphase and anaphase. So, what are the basic things that these checkpoints will do? The first one, the G1 to S checkpoint will check the accumulated size for the DNA replication that will repair the damaged DNA and it maintain the cell sizes and all. If all the things, all the requirements are fulfilled by then it will allow the cell to go to the next stage, which is the S phase. In the S phase, the DNA synthesis occurs. Then it comes to the G2 phase. G2 phase, these are the things that will happen. And after that, G2 to N phase, the second checkpoint will perform. What will it do? It check the damaged DNA. It will check the proper RNA, protein, enzymes are properly formed or properly formulated. And after that, in the third checkpoint, they will check the formation of the spindle fiber and the attachment of the spindle fiber with the centromere, the proper attachment of the spindle fiber with the centromere. If all these things are done, then it comes to the telophase and the divisional phase, and the division will form, will occur, and the two daughter cells will be formed. And we have a whole cell cycle that is complete. This is the diagrammatic view where we can see the cell cycle checkpoint. The first one is the G1 to S is zero DNA contact, and the second one is the G2 to N checkpoint. There have been completed DNA replication, it will be checked here, and the metaphase and the checkpoint, and are all of your chromosomes aligned at the equator? You will check. Now I come to the next slide. What is that? The core component of cell cycle in gene are cyclin dependent protein kinases, which is called the CDK, and their regulatory subunits cyclins. CDK and cyclin are conserved throughout the evolution. The second point is that there is only one essential CDK, generally called CDK1 in body is. And Saccharomyces cerevisiae and fission yeast, which is called the Schizosaccharomyces foamii, whereas there are several in numbers, CDK1 to CDK6, there are many. Same is true for cyclin. This is CLB B type and CLN type cyclin, while metazoans have A, B, C, D and E type cyclins. So what are the cyclin and what are the CDK? What is that? So, three. So the thing is that concentration constant throughout the cell cycle. These are the characteristic of a CDK cycling dependent protein kinase. And what are the example of it? So the cycling dependent protein kinase in case of Saccharomyces cerevisiae, in case of Saccharomyces cerevisiae, that is the fission yeast, it will be CDK 127 CDC2 and CDC28. This is all found in the Saccharomyces only. But in case of cerevisiae, we can count only this CDC28. And what is the characteristic of the cycling? Cycling can accelerate over a period and after that it will be stopped. That is the concentration is not constant throughout the cell cycle. That is the actual character of the cycling, is that it will accumulate and after its function will be done, it will also destroy after its function. So this is the cycling and the CDK. And here the example of the cycling is CDC13. This is a kind of cycling. Now, come to the PBD. So, the next slide, we can see the mechanism of CDK regulation, the activity of CDK, the inhibitor of the molecular mechanism, the cycling process, how the CDK will form. So, in the next slide, discovery of ATA. So, what is ATA? ATA means the maturation promoting factor or the mitosis promoting factor, which is that. How many experiments on frog, meiosis, Yoshio Kasumi and Clement Marquet hypothesized the presence of a cytoplasmic factor, which they named maturation promoting factor MPF, is responsible for entry into the egg phase of both mitotic and meiotic cell cycle. The discovery of MPF thus paved the way to understanding a cell cycle regulatory apparatus that is conserved throughout all eukaryotes. month, the molecule that characterization of APA in cellular laboratory showed that these conserved regulator of the cell cycle is composed of two key subunits. The first one is the CDK1 and the second one is the cyclin B. Cyclin B is a regulatory subunit required for catalytic activity of the CDK1 protein kinase. Consistent with the notion that APA activity is controlled by the periodic accumulation, this is the main thing, is that periodic accumulation and the degradation of the cyclin B during the cell cycle progression, which I told in the earlier slide that the concentration of cyclin is not constant. The next slide. Now we can see the process of the APA. So now I will come to your keys in APA. What is that? Actually, what is that? So APA. APA. Maturation protein factor. Okay. So আমরা ঠিকই জানলাম যে APA তে দুটো পার্ট থাকলো, তার মানে একটা হচ্ছে CDK. As a CDK, এখানে আমরা নিচ্ছি CDC2, যেটা main performing component, and the cyclin. Here we take CDC13. Okay. Now, this is CDC13, and this is CDC2. Okay. Now, what is that? It will produce the tyrosine phosphorylation. Okay, after the phosphorylation or the removal of the phosphate group, the APA still active. So, APA is not going to be able to do it. Equally, next stage of the ASHA, equally, ASHA will say CAA. CAA means CDK activating kinase. After the phosphorylation, the APA will activate. That's why APA activate. APA activate হওয়া মানে বেটা G2 থেকে A phase এ যাওয়াটাকে যদি কোনো ড্যামেজ থাকে, if a damage will occur or if a damage will have, so it will arrest the cell in this phase, in the G2 to M cycle. The main thing is that the CDC 25. If the CDC particular gene will not produce the tyrosine phosphatase, then the tyrosine phosphatase will not dephosphorylate the threonine and tyrosine. And if the threonine and tyrosine will phosphorylate, will not dephosphorylate, then the threonine 161 and will not form, and the indium will not active. So the main thing which to ban is CDC25. Now I come to science. Here we can see the second B, CDK1, the threonine 161, tyrosine 15, CDK14, and the dephosphorylation will occur, and the only the thing is that the second B, active MPA, after the activation of the MPA, it will detach the cyclin and B, and the CDK1 will detach, and the cyclin B will degrade it, and the CDK1 again comes to the cycle, and dephosphorylation occur, phosphate will detach, and the cyclin B again that will becomes, and it will be again joined together, and the phosphorylation will occur, and again this is the cycle. So active fibrillation, CDK1 forms complexes with cyclin B during G. CDK1 is then phosphorylated on threonine 161, which is required for CDK1 activity, as well as on tyrosine 15 and threonine 14 in vertebrate cells, which inhibit CDK1 activity. Dephosphorylation of threonine 14 and tyrosine 15 activates MPA and the G2A transition. MPA activity is then terminated towards the end of the mitosis by protein-like degradation of the cyclin B. Okay, now I come to the slides. Next slide. The G1 checkup. What is the function? During G1, cells check whether their environment favors proliferation and whether their genome is started. Genome is ready to be replicated. This control point is for the start increase and the restriction point in the number cell. Second point is that most start in the body is and the restriction point in the number cells are irreversible transition, which can't be reverted back into its original position. The next slide. Complexes of cyclin dependent kinases is percent through stir is controlled by CDLD in association with G1 cyclin, CLNL, CLN2, and CLN3. Complexes of CDK1 with distinct B type cyclin then regulate the progression through the S phase and entry into the mitosis. In animal cells, progression through the G1 restriction point is controlled by complexes of CDK4 and CDK6. With D-type cyclin, CDK2/cyclin E complexes function later in the G and are required for the G2S transition. CDK2/cyclin A complexes are then required for the progression through the S phase. CDK1/cyclin A regulate progression to G2, and CDK1/cyclin B complexes drive the G2A transition. The next slide. Restriction of DNA replication in one spark cell cycle. Restriction of DNA replication. DNA replication is restricted to one spark cell cycle by the HCN helicase protein. HCN means the mini maintenance chromosome. This is the HCN, mini chromosome maintenance complexes. Helicase protein that bind to the origin of replication together with ORC, that is the origin of replication, the place where the eukaryotic replication will start. The origin of replication, it will be multiple in case of eukaryotic, but in case of prokaryotic, it will be only one. And where we call it is the origin, ORC. The proteins are required for the initiation of DNA replication. HCN proteins are only able to bind to the DNA in G1, allowing DNA replication to initiate in S phase. Once initiation has occurred, the HCN proteins are displaced so that replication cannot initiate again anti-apoptosis. That means that if NCN will not present, the replication will not form, or the ECD of the replication will not form. So say, next slide.
Thank you.
as a result of these mutations prevent G1 agonist in response to DNA damage. So the damaged DNA is replicated and passed on to the daughter cell instead of being repaired. Inheritance of damaged DNA results in an increased frequency of the mutations and general instability of the cellular genome, which contribute to cancer development. The next thing, role of p53 G1 agonist. The protein p53 plays a key role in cell cycle agonist and the G1 checkpoint in mammalian cells. Phosphorylation by ATM and CHK2 stabilize p53, resulting in rapid increase in p53 levels in response to DNA damage. The protein p53 then activates transcription of the gene encoding the CDK inhibitor p21, leading to the inhibition of CDC2/cyclin D complexes and cell cycle events. Now I come to the next slide. The summary of the cell cycle checkpoint. So what are the cell cycle checkpoint? In a nutshell, a cell cycle, a clock is running within the cell of synthesis and the degradation of the cyclin, which activate the cyclin-dependent kinases, the CDKs, which activate other protein to cause the checkpoint transitions. The clock is adjusted, cyclin and CDKs are regulated by other protein. Based on the external signals, the growth factors, which are the hormones or the other signals which are regulated externally, and also the internal signals, the correct completion of the previous step. And the next thing, which is apoptosis, the programmed cell. So, this is all about the cell cycle checkpoint and its regulation and all that. And now I come to the apoptosis. Apoptosis, which is called the PCD or programmed cell death. How a cell which is unnecessary or damaged cell, which is not necessary to the body, so how the body will destroy it and how to it eliminate from our body. The process program is called the apoptosis. Okay, so what is this? So apoptosis will occur in a two-step process. So first of all, I come to the site first. So the morphology of apoptosis, what is that? Morphological changes that occur during apoptosis. The first, this is the first picture, A. The normal cell, this is a normal cell where you can see the serotonin, the nucleus, all the things, cell membrane and all things. The B, the second one, shrink and the condensed chromatin collapses into prison around the nuclear envelope. So the cell starts shrinking. It will start shrinking. The third picture, the membrane begins to bulge and the break. The membrane constituents or the membrane structure will tear and it starts the bleeding or it starts the bulging. The fourth one, the bleeding increases and the cell finally breaks into a number of active bodies. Here, the bleeding initially increases, eventually increases and it will break and form the small apoptic bodies, which lies in vitro, lying in vitro and the phagocytosis in vitro. Then, the other cell will phagocyte the apoptic body. Okay, so what is PCD? It will happen in the two way. First one is the external pathway. And the second one is the internal pathway. External pathway, how it works. Suppose this is a cell membrane. space is. Here we'll form the two token. The last one is the S space A, and this is A A D. So what is the full form of TRADB and FADB? TRADB. T stands for TNA. R receptor, A associated, D with domain. TNA receptor associated with domain. So where is the TNA receptor? This TNA receptor will situate here. This is the TNA receptor. So what is the full form of TNA? TNA means tumor necrosis factor. Tumor necrosis factor, which is a receptor, and the receptor associated domain is called TRADB. And FADB is stands for FADB, is fast receptor associated death domain. So here the fast receptor. So fast stands for fast apoptosis signal. This is called the fast. FAS, and here the ligand will come. This is, and also this is the first ligand. After the attachment of the ligand with the receptor, the caspase 8 will be activated. And after the activation of the caspase 8, the internal pathway will begin. So after the activation of the caspase 8, it will activate the internal pathway. So what is the internal pathway? The internal pathway. What is that? After the activation of caspase 8, and start from caspase 8 here. It will break the beet protein breakage. Something like this is a beet protein, and after the break it will form like this. Okay? So beet protein. So what is the beet protein? Member of a BCL2 gene family. So BCL2, B cell lymphocyte 2 family. Here this is of two types. One is pro-apoptotic. And one is anti-apoptotic. So the example of the pro-apoptotic is the beet, B-I-D, beet, bats, and knots. These are the example of pro-apoptotic, which actually trigger the apoptotic pathway, or it will help the apoptosis pathway to occur. And the anti-apoptotic, which is the against, which inhibit the apoptotic pathway. And this is the example of anti-apoptotic is BCL8 and BCL2. These are the anti-apoptotic. So after the, let me place this. So we have the breakage, and the breakage on the single part is called the truncated beet. After second step, next step is the attachment of truncated bead with mitochondrial membrane, AT membrane, means mitochondrial membrane. So how is it? Suppose this is a mitochondrial membrane. And the truncated bead will attach like this. And after the attachment, it changes the permeability of the cell membrane. It will change the permeability of the cell membrane. antibodies in it, and then it form the pore in the membrane. In the membrane, and for that, what will happen? It will secrete the cytochrome C. Cytochrome C comes out from the pore. So these are the cytochrome C, which is comes out from the pore, and after the cytochrome C becomes out, cytochrome C will attach with the 7 molecule of cytochrome C plus 7 molecule of APAF1. Okay, attach with prokaspase 9, and together these three together form apoptosome. So how it looks? Then we see cytochrome C 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 molecule of cytochrome C. This is 7 molecule of APAF1. And this is prokaspase 9. Okay. Cytochrome C. APAF1. And this is prokaspase 9. Together it will form the apoptosome. Apoptosome. And after the formation of apoptosome, it will activate. It reactivate caspase 3. So what is the function of the caspase 3? So caspase 3 is the main one which actually performs in the, which has the main function in the apoptotic pathway. So what is it? It will degrade, or it will destroy the cell by 3. What is this? It will degrade the protein. Either protein degradation. Either protein degradation or by activation of DFF. Activation of DFF. DFF means DNA fragmenting factor. That means it will degrade the DNA. Suppose this is a DNA strand, and the DFF will fragmenting this, and after that the DNA will look like this. It's a DNA fragmentation. It will break the DNA, and by membrane degradation. This is the case that how the caspase 3 work, and it will arrest the cell, or it will damage the cell, and after this the cell will dead, or apoptosis will occur. So now I come again into my PPTs, and the next thing is that after the apoptosis, so this is the references from where I took the things from my PPTs, and this is thank you to the class, thank you students.